a bleak forecast for the global economy. The World Bank expects global growth to decelerate sharply from 5.5% in 2021 to 4.1% in 2022. It warns global growth could decrease further to 3.4% due to potential economic disruptions caused by the Omicron variant. The multilateral lender also sharply lowering its 2022 forecast for the world's two largest economies. As for the Philippines, the World Bank projects a 5.9% economic growth this year, supported by sustained public investments and recovering household consumption.
U.S. inflation soars to its fastest pace in four decades. The Consumer Price Index surged 7%, the biggest increase since June 1982. The jump was driven by price increases in housing and used cars and trucks. It also comes as the pandemic continues to hit supply chains with renewed lockdowns due to the Omicron variant. December's 7% inflation is well above the Federal Reserve's 2% target, supporting expectations the central bank could raise interest rates as early as March. Economists expect the Fed to hike rates 3 to 4 times this year.
We started to see measurable improvement in the supply chain such that it really reduced the price pressures. That does take some pressure off the Fed, or it just helps them get from here to there with fewer rate hikes in the short term. However, the supply chain issue has been around a lot longer than we thought it was going to be. We're pretty close to peak inflation now. I mean, it's really only evident in hindsight, but we might be pretty close to that right now. But that's little consolation, because although the rate of inflation may moderate, prices are still going up, and they're still going to go up at a much faster pace than what we have become accustomed to.
Canada's second most populous province is eyeing a different but also controversial vaccination rule. As this report tells us, Quebec plans to tax adults refusing to get a COVID jab.
Residents refusing a COVID-19 vaccine in Canada's Quebec province may soon have to pay a tax instead. Governments around the world have imposed varying restrictions on the unvaccinated, but a sweeping tax would be a rare and controversial move. Citing the financial burden unvaccinated people are putting on the system, Premier François Legault said on CTV Tuesday that the tax would likely be up to 100 Canadian dollars, or around 80 US dollars.
Those who refuse to receive their first dose.
He added that the unfinished proposal wouldn't apply to those who can't get vaccinated for medical reasons. Provinces across Canada are experiencing exponential surges in COVID-19 cases due to the Omicron variant, and Quebec is one of the worst hit. Last month, Quebec said it had no choice but to allow some essential workers to continue working, even after testing positive for the virus, in order to prevent staff shortages from halting healthcare services. Legault says that even though only 10% of the province population remains unvaccinated, they make up about 50% of their intensive care units. Whether a tax on the unvaccinated could survive court challenges will depend on the details. On Monday, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau said that the federal government had secured enough vaccine doses for all eligible Canadians to receive a booster as well as a fourth dose.
Morocco considering tax incentives to attract foreign investors and doctors that can fill the gaps in its health system. It is also considering wage hikes for health workers to keep doctors in public practice and to attract more staff from overseas. According to the country's health minister, the pandemic has caused a shortage of around 32,000 doctors and 65,000 nurses. Morocco is Africa's most vaccinated country, but the Omicron variant has sent COVID-19 cases soaring to over 7,000 on Tuesday, compared with just 100 last month. Authorities believe the surge will only peak by early February.
Meanwhile, in sports news, tennis top seed Novak Djokovic reveals an administrative error on his entry document to Australia. The Australian government is still studying what to do with his visa days before he's set to defend his Australian Open crown. This report.
Novak Djokovic admitted on Wednesday that an incorrect answer was made on his Australia entry forms. The world number one tennis star's visa to play in the Australian Open is still in doubt as government officials now consider whether to deport him over the error. Giving false or misleading information is an offence carrying a maximum penalty of 12 months in prison and a fine of up to $4,730. It can also lead to the cancellation of the offender's visa. Djokovic said his travel declaration was filled in by his support team, who made an administrative mistake. The team member ticked the no box in response to whether he had travelled elsewhere in the 14 days before arriving in Australia. Questions arose about the Serbian star's movements when social media posts appeared to show him in Belgrade less than 2 weeks before he headed to Spain and then on to Australia. In a post on his Instagram account, he said, quote, "This was human error and certainly not deliberate. We are living in challenging times in a global pandemic, and sometimes these mistakes can occur." The player also apologises in his statement for attending an interview and photo shoot on December the 18th, the day after he said he learned he had tested positive for COVID-19 for the second time. Djokovic was only released from Melbourne's immigration detention on Monday after being held there for several days. Officials had revoked his visa amid questions over his medical exemption for a requirement to be vaccinated against COVID-19. That decision was quashed by a judge on Monday, who called the cancellation of his visa unreasonable. The tennis star now faces the possibility of having his visa revoked for a second time, just days before he's due to defend his title at the Australian Open.